Life.
Assalamu alaikum everyone and good afternoon. I'm Sundus Mubashir from HR Consultants and today I will be hosting this session. HR Consultants is one of the top renowned consultancy agency that helps the students to go through a smooth application process when it comes to foreign education. It advises you and guides you with best suitable options that will help you build your future career. At this difficult time, HR Consultants is here to help you out. The topic of today's discussion is about the students who cannot need direct entry of the top leading universities. So for those solution we have for those students we have a solution for them. They can secure their places and avail this opportunity through the support of education pathway providers. And one such pathway providers we'll be discussing today. That is Cambridge Education Group. Now, this Cambridge Education Group is education pathway provider which has been training students to progress into world leading universities through their high quality of teaching and education profiles. I have with me Ms. Nakashi Arshad, who is USA Admission Team Officer at HR Consultants, and Mr. Sameer, who is the Regional Manager of Cambridge Education Group for USA. So, before proceeding for further discussion, I would like to invite you that you can drop in your queries in the comment section below so that they can be answered accordingly. And for application, you can drop in your documents at 0346-4747-024. Now I hand over discussion to Ms. Nakashia. Ms. Nakashia, please proceed.
Thank you so much, Sundas, for introducing Cambridge Education Group with us. Hi, Sameer. Hope you are enjoying certain time over there at home as well. Before we start with this particular session, there are a few queries, few questions which have been asked randomly by our students as well, and we are also concerned about the current situation. So we'll start with the basic general questions and then we'll move towards the specific questions related to the COVID-19 situation. How about if you start briefing about Cambridge Education Group yourself and your role in this education group, for how long you have been working with CEG, please.
Yeah, sure. So my role with On Campus is that I support you guys and our students to find the right solution for them. As mentioned earlier, what On Campus and Cambridge Education Group do is we support students who do not meet their entry requirements to go directly to the university. So we can give an opportunity to study in the US by being flexible with the entry requirements and then finding a solution and the right university for the students to then progress on to. I've been doing this for probably around about now 7 to 8 years, and I have seen a lot of success in the students who have come with maybe, let's just say, a little bit lower entry requirements to then progress to higher ranking universities.
Right. As Sameer, you have already mentioned that you have been serving for last 6, 7, 8 years about US education system. Why do you recommend students to study in US in comparison to the other major destinations, that is Australia, UK, or Canada? Why do you recommend US?
So with the US, it's very easy. I'd say the number one is that the flexibility. So students don't actually have to choose their major until their second year of their undergraduate degree. So they could essentially come to us for the first year, get an understanding of what major they want to do, let's just say if it's within business or engineering or sciences, but they don't actually choose their major until they move into the second year of their university program. So I say that brings them a little bit advantages compared to different other destinations such as Australia and the UK. The second thing is career opportunities. What the US do provide is STEM options. So we at On Campus do also have that STEM option with IIT and with Boston. Students can do one semester of work and then a second semester of studying. So they get that straight away, they're on that working opportunities within the US. The third, I would say, is ranking in the QS and Times education ranking. US universities, I would say there are about 30 different universities in the US world which are ranked in the top 50. So that's also gives students a higher opportunity of studying at a top ranked university. I would say also diversity, the amount of students that come from very different destinations to the US is huge. So it gives other students the opportunity to learn about other cultures and meet new people as well. And then I would say campus life. I mean, we all see it in films and movies about the campus lifestyle of the US. And it is a very different lifestyle compared to a lot of other destinations. So it gives, again, the students the opportunity to have a different lifestyle, but also gives them the opportunity to study on campus, live on campus, but then also be quite close to a lot of city nightlives and things like that as well, which again, other destinations don't always have that. Some destinations have universities are based in the city and it's a very city lifestyle, whereas these students in the US, it's more about the campus.
Right, as we see that there are many reasons for the international students to study in the US. Could you please brief us about the US education system, that how many credit hours one needs to complete for completion of degree, or it's the number of years? Because in other destinations, we consider it as a specifically number of years for the completion of a degree. What do you say about the US education system for our international students who are not familiar with this particular education system and they are new to it?
So sometimes the US can be seen a little bit complicated in terms of years and credits and things like that. But essentially, the simple way to look at it is for undergraduate students, it's 4 years. And for graduate students, it's 2 years. There is the complication of the number of credits, but that is all based on students once they arrive. So depending on the student's ability, the number of credits they study can vary depending on students. And for example, students who are doing masters in the graduate program could essentially finish their program within 1 year and a half instead of 2 years, because if they've got the ability to do more credits, they can finish the course a lot sooner. With on campus, with Boston and IIT, we do ours based on credits as well as years. So for example, students would do the first year of 9 credits per semester when they're studying an undergraduate program. So they get 18 credits, which then they transfer to the second year. What that means is once they go into second year, they could essentially do more credits, but it's all based on the student's ability. But best way to look at it is 4 years for undergraduate students and 2 years for graduate students.
Right. Since you need to let us know about your institutions as well on campus, Boston and IIT as well, where they're located, what they have been doing, and how students will be progressing to the same institutions or to any other world-leading institutions after completion of their degrees or during their studies.
So we have IIT. So IIT is one of the very highly ranked universities. So it's ranked 117th in the US. Which is actually means it's top 150 university, and it's actually in the top 1% in the world in terms of ranking. So it is our highest ranking university partner that we do have. We offer them, university is based in Chicago, and it has pretty much ranges programs from everything from business, engineering, sciences, arts, humanities. Our students, although we are offering a pathway option, they don't essentially study another extra year. So it's not like we're saying 5 years, they will be studying 4 years. The first year will be with us, and then they transfer the credits directly to the university. The teaching is actually the university teachers. It's not on campus, or it's not a campus based somewhere else. They'll be based on the campus of the university. Essentially what we provide is we're gonna be giving them extra support, extra time, guidance, and the opportunity to give them that chance to study at a higher ranking university. With On Campus Boston, it's based in Boston. It's based at Curry College, and I can see that the video is playing right now. You can see a lot of people would assume this is a community-based college. It is not a community-based college. It is a public university which has a range of undergraduate degrees. However, with On Campus, the first year is with us. Our team would then support the students to base the program on what they want to do. So for example, if we have a student who wants to do art, who wants to do business, the program will be designed based on that. And then we will support that student to progress to another university that they want to go to. We normally say a minimum of 6 universities you can apply to after the first year. Our team will support the student to write the personal statement, provide them guidance on the application form. If there's interviewing preparation, we would also do that, making sure that that student goes to the university that they want to study at. We do have a really good example. This year, we had a student who has now progressed to Cornell University. So it just shows that students are progressing to higher ranking universities from Boston.
Right. which kind of courses do they study in the first year, in the freshman year with the on-campus Boston?
It depends. So it depends purely on the student. If they want to do business, our modules be based around the modules of business modules. If they've come in to study with us in sciences, our modules will be based very much related to sciences and engineering.
They're studying all the major courses which will be counted towards their degree.
So all our programs in the first year are credit based, so they will transfer those credits to the second year of the university that they're going to. So we essentially, I believe a bit it's 32 credits that they will earn while studying with us, and then they'll progress it to the second year of the university, whichever university that they go to. It'll be
great. So me, at the moment, since pandemic is going on, every university is offering somewhat flexibilities for regarding admissions in USA. So do CEG help students regarding this matter? In this pandemic, do they offer any flexibilities in the entry requirement?
Yes, we do have a lot of flexibility. So for example, SATs are not required for the first year of undergraduate students. Also GRE and GMAT is also not required for our graduate students. So there's no requirement for that. We also do provide the opportunity for students to go directly to the university at IIT. This year alone, due to the current situation, IIT are no longer requiring GRE or GMAT for direct entry as well. The other great opportunities and also puts the US on the map in terms of a little bit more flexibility is the requirement of English. So for our students and also for Pakistani students, so students have studied the HSC, as long as they've got a C or above in their English and the HSC level, we do not require IELTS or TOEFL. So we can use that as a requirement for English. The other option is if students do have a below C or a C in their English or HSC level, we do have a number of internal English tests we can do online. So we have the Duolingo, we have the Pearson Versant test, we also have the password test, which is all can be done online. No requirement for students having to go to an IELTS test center or TOEFL test center.
Are these tests free of cost or do we need to pay for something?
There's no costs at all for the English. They can all be done online for free through you guys, through HR, come to you, and then you guys come to us and we can arrange the English test online.
Right. Can you specifically highlight the entry criteria for our OA level students and our HSSC students as well? That how much percentage they need to attain in their HSSC results so that they can progress to the university?
Sure. So for O-level students, we require 5 Cs. For GCSE level is exactly the same. We need 5 Cs. Again, with Boston, there could be an element of flexibility there. If a student has got, like, for example, 3 Cs or 4 Cs, what we do and what a partner provider like OnCampus can do is we refer those students to OnCampus Boston. And then if the profile of the student is very strong, the opportunity is that they can be accepted onto the course, even though they've got below 5 Cs. The same for A-level students, we require 2 Es and they can join our undergraduate program. For HSC students, for Boston, it's 40%. For IIT, it's 50%. So yes. And I don't think there is anything else. But for English, if the students do have an IELTS, we accept a 4.5 at Boston and 5.5 for IIT.
Great. So I need, Samir, I need a clarification again, since the news has it that the students will be progressed on their previous results, especially HSCC student, because the news is between whether they will attempt the test or they won't be attempting the test, especially our HSCC students. So I want a clear idea that how it will be assessed, how they will be progressed to the, how CEG will progress them in the programs.
So do you mean if the students have not completed their 12 years, they've completed only 11 years, for example? Those students will be referred to our university, and depending on their academic grades, then we can assess them whether we can accept them or not. It will always be based on their academic grades, their current grades right now. Again, there may be sometimes situations where we aren't able to. For IIT, I will be honest with you, IIT may be a little bit more difficult, but those students can then be referred to on-campus Boston, where there is a little bit of extra flexibility where we could accept the students.
Tell us something about the scholarships and the criteria to apply for those particular scholarships.
Okay, so for scholarships, we have a number of different scholarships. So for example, at Boston, we only provide an undergraduate pathway program there. Those students, as long as they meet the academic entry requirements, we can provide them a $20,000 scholarship. There is no element of extra work or any personal statements or CVs required for that. As long as they meet the entry requirements, we can accept them with the scholarship. With IIT, we have two, which is the undergraduate scholarship. That is $22,000. Again, there's no extra requirements there. As long as they meet the entry requirements, we can provide them the scholarship. For graduate students, we provide a $8,000 scholarship, but that is for the first year only, and it's split into two. So $4,000 for the first semester, $4,000 for the second semester.
Okay. What do you say about the current situation that when visas will be starting?
So at the moment, it's very much dependent on the country. So it will be very much depending on, for example, in Pakistan, when the embassies open there. We do have a fairly early deadline of I-20s. We are already providing I-20s because right now the current situation with IIT and with Boston is that they are very much ready to offer face-to-face teaching. So the both universities are ready and already organizing the campus, the accommodation, to be ready for face-to-face teaching, because they also honestly believe that face-to-face teaching will be available for the fall intake. For US visas, it can take a little bit longer than many other countries. It does take around about 1 month. So we are providing our I-20s now. Last date of enrollment will be the 31st of August. So students have courses start on the 24th. So they're giving an extra 1 week of enrollments for 31st of August. Now with IIT, they are ready to offer this. There is the opportunity for students who don't arrive on time to go online, but again, they are ready to offer online or to study on campus for students. With Boston, there's a little bit more extra. They're giving until September the 11th to arrive, with courses starting on 24th of August. So there's a bit more extra time for Boston.
Great. This is very important for all the international students to know that they need to apply right now to consider it if they are going for the fall intake. And it's likely, especially at the on-campus Boston, that they'll have face-to-face sessions for the fall intake. So to secure your visas, you need to drop in your documents. You need to WhatsApp us for your profiles assessment so that we can get your offer letters issued and we can proceed towards the I-20 documentation.
Yeah, so great thing that we are offering right now is that we are allowing students to pay a deposit of $300. As long as they provide us their academic documents, they've met the entry requirements, we can issue the I-20. The first term's fees are not required until just before they enroll onto the course. So all they need to do right now to get their I-20 is provide us the $300. Provide us the academic documents, proof of level of English, and their bank statements, and then they can then be issued the I-20.
So if the session was online at any due to any circumstances for the fall intake, so they would be continuing paying $300 only for the first semester online session, or they need to pay at that time as well?
No, so for online session, it's exactly the same. So then if they are coming to join, if I'm being completely honest, we are not even thinking about online right now. We are just thinking that our students are going to be studying face-to-face. Again, IIT are ready to offer online because they've got the technology to offer that. So they've already told us online is an option if required for our students, but we are ready to go face-to-face. For the $300, it's essentially for the I-20, for students to achieve the I-20. They do need to pay their first-term fees before they arrive. So that will be needing to be paid. Now, if they're going online and they've paid the $300 and they don't want to do online, then that's it. There's no requirement for them to pay anything else, and they can then defer their course to January. So we have that. We also have our refund policy ready for any students who require it as well, if they wanted to not go online.
Samir, so you're saying that if the student pays $300, so and suddenly due to circumstances, student withdraws taking online courses or online classes, do you offer any refund policy?
The 300 is there is no refund policy. If a student has paid their first term fees, they will get their full fees back.
Okay. So we will be taking few questions we have online. A student is asking, what is the due to the current pandemic situations, if a student has to give IELTS, what is the minimum band that is required for USA?
So if they've taken IELTS, it's a 4.5 with no band less than 4.5 for Boston. If they want to come to IIT, it's 5.5 and no band less than 5.5 for IIT. But please remember, IELTS is not an essential requirement if they've already done HSC and have a C or above.
Right. What in terms of percentage? How do you clarify the C in terms of percentage for the English?
So I believe a C is 50%. So if they've got a 50% or above in their English at HSC level, we can accept that and no requirement for IELTS or TOEFL.
Okay, that's good to know.
Mm-hmm.
Any other queries, Sundas, please?
So, Samir, how does it go? Sorry. So, Samir, how does it go? How does it it goes that you guys, CEG offers foundation programs or diploma courses? What is the scenario in USA regarding this?
So, essentially, our programs are not seen as a foundation or a diploma. It's seen as the first year of their undergraduate or first year of their graduate. So we are not actually asking the students to study anything extra. They are still studying the same number of years they would be if they're going directly. The advantages that they get coming through to us rather than going directly to a university is that, first of all, our classes are a lot more smaller, so they get the extra attention and extra support. So essentially, most of the students that are coming to us, like you said at the beginning of the show, was that students who don't meet the entry requirements to go directly, they require a pathway. Now, the best thing about the US pathway is that we are not asking students to study any extra years, which means there are no extra fees. They're still paying the same amount of fees they would be if they're going directly, but they get the time and the support and extra English classes, essentially, because a lot of times the students who have come into us have not got the English requirement to then progress onto the second year of their university program. And that gives them a better chance to progress to get the best academic grade. So when they do complete their program, that they are going to get the best job they are available to them as well.
Okay. Another important query that will CEG be catering students with few years education gap as well?
Yes. So when students have gaps in their studies, so let's just say if they've got a 2-year gap, what is required is students need to provide us a personal statement and a CV to let us know what they've been doing. Sometimes, in some cases, our center heads at IIT and Boston may ask the student to have an interview, but this is very on a rare occasion. But generally what we require is a personal statement and a CV just so we are aware of what they're doing. So then we are able to make sure that we're ready when they do arrive to our courses, that they get the guidance that they need so that they have the best opportunity to continue to progress in the US as well. But yes, we do consider students with study gaps.
Right, because we do see many students who have been like joining their family businesses after completion of HSC or A-level studies, and then after 1 to 2 years, they decide to recontinue their studies. So we need to know what they need to provide for this clarification if they will be considered. So we'll definitely let all the international students who specifically have a 1 year or 2 years education gap, they need to prepare their CVs, their statement of purposes to explain us that what they have been doing in this time period.
That'd be perfect, yes.
Tell us something about the accommodation arrangements on campus Boston and IIT have for the international students.
So for both our accommodation is available on campus. So in terms of transport to the university campuses or lectures, it's going to be this, everything is walking distance. So they'll be studying and living on campus. The first year of accommodation is available to students, guaranteed accommodation is available to the students. And then in the second year, the students can then decide whether they want to continue on the campus or if they want to get their own accommodation. But this is all available on campus. they will have the opportunity to decide what type of accommodation they want. Do they want one with their own bathroom, or do they want to share? We have that flexibility again for the accommodation for students to decide what they want and where they want to stay.
Right. Thank you so much, Tamir, for giving this information. Before we close this particular session, I want you to briefly tell us about the fee structures after the scholarship amounts for the students, so that they know what they have to pay for a 1 year study and a 1 year living expenses there approximately, so that they can make up their minds for the study in on campus Boston and IIT.
Okay, so for the first year, so after scholarship at IIT, the cost will be, I believe, will be about 26,000-27,000 USD for the first year. That's with a 22K scholarship. And then if you're including accommodation, it's around about 15,000. So you're looking at a full package for 1 year, about 40,000 USD. For the second year, for Boston, it's a 20,000 scholarship. So you bring the fees down to 20K. With the accommodation, you're looking at, again, around about 12 to 15,000. So you're looking at about 35K for Boston. And that is, with accommodation plus tuition fees. And then normally with the US, you also need to remember health insurance as well. Again, on campus, we'll support the students with the health insurance as well. But the best part is, if they want to secure their place right now, is 300 USD reg fee for them to then be issued the I-20.
Exactly, right. Okay.
So, Sameer, before ending this session, I have few questions online. Students who have done pre-medical in HSCC, they're asking the basic entry requirements for life sciences and medicine fields that CEG can support them when it comes to admission.
If they've got a medical background?
Yes.
Are they looking for masters or undergraduates?
Bachelors, or MBBS programs, or bachelors in biomedical sciences, or biotechnology, biomedical engineering, such courses. What is the progression? What is the entry requirement that CEG offers?
It's exactly the same as our students for any other program. So again, but if they've got already a pre-medical background, they need to understand that they will need to do a undergraduate in life sciences to then go into masters of medicine to then be able to get an MBBS. Because international students in the US or even in Canada, when they're looking to get a medicine degree, they are unable to get a medicine degree unless they have a bachelor's in life sciences to then go into a master's. So it does take a lot longer for medicine students for the US.
Great. Any other question from your end, Sundas, please?
Till now, I think this is for today. So as soon as questions will be coming, we will be definitely contacting you. Please share your contact details, Sameer, so that the students can get their inquiries entertained. And I would again invite my viewers, the students who are watching this session, this is the best opportunity to apply in USA universities. Students, especially intermediate, O-levels and A-level students, they have this best opportunity. They can avail the scholarship of between $20,000 to $22,000. They can pay an initial deposit and secure their place at USA universities at a cost of $300. And you can apply through a smooth process by dropping your documents on 0346474704. Sameer, before ending this session, please give any message, any motivating message for our students here in Pakistan.
Yeah, I just want to say, please do obviously stay safe. And again, we are here to support you. And if you're looking for that second chance to improve your academic grades and to actually have the opportunity to study at a top-ranked university, then please do obviously contact the HR consultants team, who can then provide you guys the guidance and support to study in the US. And hopefully maybe one day we will see you at IIT or at Boston.
Sure. Thank you so much. Do you have any message to share with our viewers?
Yes, this is very, very much lucrative for the students to know that it's just a $300 as an initial deposit for them to make an entrance at the US institutions. So please drop us your documents, drop us your queries at 0246-4747024. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you, Sundas. Thank you, Samir, for
Thank you very much for your time. Thank you, Ms. Nagashia. Please send in your documents on 0346-4747024. Thank you so much, everyone. Allah Hafiz.
Thank you.